Latif channel, where you will find some coaching short videos regarding business. Usually I summarize in this video a chapter from Maverick Leadership, my new book, which is an easy read of 250 pages and is loaded with practical advice for entrepreneurs, general managers, and CEOs with proven tools to manage your business and grow your sales and bottom line and take your business to the next level. But for this fourth video, I would like to comment on the recent acquisition of Whole Foods by Amazon for in mid-June for $13 billion. I want to go on record with some of my observation and share them with you. The acquisition has been applauded by just about all the experts, saying that there will be a lot of benefits to Amazon, and there is no doubt about that. Obviously, there is a reason why Amazon purchased or want to acquire Whole Foods. However, though, I want to go on record in saying that this move may not be the best one for Amazon, and I'm going to give you my reason. Also, I predict that the grocery players, which appear to be heading to a bumpy road ahead, may not be that of a bad situation, and Amazon really has stepped in into a minefield. So let me share my thoughts with you. Number one, Amazon has been trying to get into the grocery business segment for many years and unsuccessfully. So the acquisition of Whole Foods will give it 460 stores, a good distribution channel. And if Amazon can add its expertise in online selling, that's a successful kind of combination. No doubt about that. But here are my reasons. Number one, Amazon is a great online retailer, offering low price and convenience. Whole Foods is a high-end grocery serving the upmarket. The two cultures are completely, in my opinion, opposed and different. Can the two cultures cohabit together? Can they work together? My assessment is that with great difficulty. If you read Maverick Leadership, I explain how Daimler-Benz culture and Chrysler could not work together, which happened, and that they sold Chrysler at the end. Culture, corporate culture, cannot be counted and cannot be measured, but it's a real thing. And if you underestimate the power of corporate culture, then you are taking a big risk. Number two, Amazon has built a $150 billion business with a market valuation of $450 billion, credit to them, in 23 short years. But that recipe depends on keeping the top line growing fast or making it on the bottom line, which up to today, Amazon has not been performing very well on the bottom line. So it is that pressure of either or that probably is fueling that strategic acquisition. And here is what I'm saying, that making a decision strategically under pressure, it looks like you're reacting to circumstances rather than a well-thought strategy. And that is, again, is very risky. Number three, while some consumers no doubt will also try purchasing their grocery online, I just have a little bit of hesitation that people are gonna let students, part-time students, select their fruit and vegetable, fresh produce, and pack it and deliver it for them. I think there is consumers would like to go through the aisle, see what's fresh today, and then buy it and pack it themselves. I stand to be corrected, but I think this is something to be proven. Also, you cannot pack fresh fruits and vegetables like you're packing a book, and you probably need refrigeration as well. So there are some complexity in the execution of that strategy. Fourth, and my last comment here, is that Amazon is jumping into the grocery arena where it will compete with some big guys, the Walmart, the Kroger, the Costco, and Target. These are big players with a lot of experience, a lot of know-how, a lot of resources. I don't think they're just going to roll over. So again here, if you read Maverick Leadership, I talk about how Loblaws, Sobeys, Metro, and Canadian Tire teamed up with Costco and Walmart to kick Target out in less than 3 years, causing billions of dollars of losses. And there was about 17,000, 1,600 employees that lost their jobs. So don't count those grocers out. I think they have experience and they will be able to give a good fight. In general, let me summarize. Acquisitions are made maybe in two buckets of reasoning. One is capturing value. The second one is to create value. Obviously, Amazon want to create value. But I have admiration for Amazon and Jeff Bezos and what they have accomplished to date. But for the future, I think that there is a question mark here. I mean, in retrospect, we are all experts, but when the ability comes when you can predict the future and you can predict what is the winning strategy. Now, here's a question for you. Can armies go through a minefield? Yes, they can, but at what cost? And that's the real question. I guess we can meet in 3 years and find out who was right and who was wrong. And in the meantime, if you have enjoyed this video and you would like to purchase Maverick Leadership, it's available on my website, hughlatif.com, also on amazon.com and CA. I hope you enjoyed this brief video. I thank you for watching, and please, before you leave, check on subscribe. Thank you for watching and have a great day.